For every jet, every tank, and every missile fired, there's a price tag, and there's a private company behind it, a defense contractor.
Raytheon's proven ballistic missile defense systems provide layered defense around the world.
The story of Lockheed Martin's first 100 years has been a story of constant innovation.
The value of performance. Northrop Grumman.
And today, for those defense contractors, business is booming.
Despite U.S. defense cuts, Lockheed Martin stock is soaring, trading at all-time highs.
Northrop Grumman, Raytheon, and General Dynamics also hit record highs in their stock prices.
In fact, if there's one lesson about defense contractors to be learned by the last few years, it's that the private defense industry is a lot stronger than it lets on.
It might be flattering to believe that our industry is so robust and so durable that it could absorb the impact of sequestration without breaking stride, but that is a fiction.
So stupid that the threat of it would be a prompt all by itself to public leaders to avoid it at any cost.
But this is like putting a proverbial Band-Aid on a bullet wound.
Sequestration happened, and the sky didn't fall at the Pentagon or for its private contractors. A new campaign in Iraq and Syria that's relying mainly on airstrikes is great news for companies like Raytheon, the producer of Tomahawk missiles. In September, the first night of airstrikes alone cost the U.S. at least $74 million in missiles. The costs of these weapons is not just a drop in the bucket. In 2014, the U.S. spent $100 billion on weapons procurement alone, more than the Departments of Education and Transportation combined. And a major reason behind that spending is cost overrun. A 2011 audit found a third of all the Pentagon's major weapons programs since 1997 had ended up costing 50% more than planned. Only one program with a cost overrun was canceled. Pentagon leaders know weapons procurement is plagued with problems, and they've been saying so for years.
We need to continually move forward with designing an acquisition system that rewards cost-effectiveness and efficiency so that our programs do not continue to take longer, cost more, and deliver less than initially planned and promised.
I'm proud of Congress for sending me this legislation. That's why I'm going to go sign it right now. Thank you very much.
Congress has tried to address the problem, like with 2009's Acquisition Reform Act. But lawmakers left military brass the option of simply waiving legal requirements for weapons programs. And that's an option they've taken many times, including with the Pentagon's most expensive program, the F-35.